This is an AI music channel. Everything you see was created with AI tools, from the music to the logo and even the description. I'll show 7 steps to creating your very own AI music YouTube channel just like this. That channel was created specifically for this tutorial, so there are no subscribers or anything like that. However, the 7 steps are simple. 1. How to create your AI music YouTube channel, complete step-by-step guide using AI. 2. How to create the AI music. 3. How to master your AI music for better sound quality. 4. How to add a smooth ending to your AI music. 5. How to prepare your channel logo for your music video. 6. How to create an audio reactor visualizer music video. And 7. How to upload it to YouTube. This is a full beginner-friendly guide on getting your very own AI music YouTube channel. Let's get started. Step 1. Creating the YouTube channel. In this step, I will focus on YouTube channel creation. However, if you're following along, it would be wise to register your social media accounts as well, on Instagram, TikTok, etc. Ready? First, we need an artist name. Hopefully you have one. If not, use ChatGPT to give you a list of artist names. I'll use this prompt. Now go through the list of names. Since 100 billion people are creating YouTube channels, we will need to check if the usernames are available. This step ensures we don't get our heart set on a name, only to find out we were the 50 millionth user to try this. So let's go to... Here, we can check YouTube channel names in bulk. We can do 10 at a time. So let's check which names are available. Chances are almost every name in the world is taken, so we may need to ask ChatGPT for more names. To do this, simply tell ChatGPT to give you more names. This process took a long time, so I ended up going with the name Rap Metal Beats. Let's now create our channel. We can do this by going to studio.youtube.com and logging in. From here, click on Settings. Next, click on Channel. Click on Advanced Settings, scroll down, select Manage YouTube Accounts. Next, click on Add or Manage YouTube Channels. Now, click on the plus Create a Channel button. Give your channel a name and click on Create. Now, you might end up with an error that says the channel does not exist. Ignore that and click on your profile pic on the upper right-hand corner and select Switch Account. You'll now see your new channel. Click on your new channel. Perfect, we now have our YouTube channel. Next, we need to make it look professional. Let's click on Customize Channel. From here, click on Branding. We now need to work on our profile picture logo and our YouTube channel banner. Let's get ourselves a logo. For this, I'll use Ideogram. Enter a prompt to get a logo. I used this prompt. Keep going until you find something you like. We get 25 free generations per day with Ideogram. You can also use Leonardo.ai or any of your favorite AI image generators. I generated lots of cool logos, which can make it hard to decide, so I recommend saving your top 5, then choosing a final from there. I'll go with this logo. Now, let's create a channel banner. For this, I will use Canva. It's free and it will get you started. The banner doesn't need to be perfect. Simple is better. In Canva, click on Create a Design. Search YouTube and click on YouTube Banner. Find a YouTube channel banner template and modify it. Once that is completed, let's upload our logo and banner. After uploading your banner and logo, click on Basic Info. Here, we will adjust our name to have spaces, and we will claim our @ handle. We also need a description. For the description, we can also use ChatGPT for this. I'll use this prompt. We can now preview what our channel looks like by clicking on View Channel. Nice. Now, to make things easier on us, in the future, when we upload new videos, we can also set up our default upload section as well as our channel tags. To do this, click on Settings. Under Channel, set your country and channel keywords. Under Advanced Settings, select No, this channel is not made for kids. Next, go to Upload Defaults. If you want to set default video settings, go ahead and do so. I personally don't. However, click on Advanced Settings tab. Set your category. Now click Save. We should now be done setting up and configuring our YouTube channel. Now we need AI music. Step 2, creating the AI music. Let's generate some AI music. For this, I like to use Udio.com or Suno.com. I personally feel these two are the best out as of now. I pay for Suno Pro Plan, which allows me to use what I generate for commercial use. Udio.com as of now is free and is beta. However, it is limited to 33-second tracks. Udio.com does allow commercial use, but for this tutorial, I will be using my credits on my Suno account. If you want a Suno prompting guide, be sure to watch this video here. For this example, I will enter the most basic prompt. I'll be using rap metal, and I will check instrumental. I'll send a bunch into queue and then sort them out once they're all generated. This takes time, so I'll preview all the tracks I like while it's still setting in. I'll go ahead and thumbs up the tracks that I do like. You'll know when it's fully completed when the extend button appears next to the track. Feel free to extend your track if you're not happy with the length, or go ahead and download them. For me, I found the track I liked and extended it 3 times. Then download the full track by clicking on the 3 dots next to the last extended track and select get whole song. Now rinse and repeat this process for every track you want. Once you got your full track, I like to master the track using a one-click solution, which brings us to step 3, mastering the AI music. This part is simple. Take your full downloaded AI music track and go to this website. It's completely free to use. Now upload your track here, and when it's complete, you'll be able to hear the difference. Select Universal, Fire, Clarity, or Tape. For me, Universal usually works best, but you can toggle through which settings you like, then click download. This will give you a wave format. Step 4, adding a reverb tail ending. This next step is to ensure we get a nice smooth ending where the music doesn't just cut off at the ending. In my prompting video, you'll be able to try different methods to achieve this through prompting. For me, I prefer to do it this way. It keeps things consistent and I don't have to mess around too much with prompting. To keep things free, for this, we will use Audacity. Download and install Audacity and launch it. Now let's drag and drop our mastered track into Audacity. Click at the ending of your track and insert some silence by clicking on Generate, then select Silence. The default settings is more than enough. Click on Generate, then slide the bottom slider to the right to reveal the ending of the track. Grab the silence track and push it towards the main track. Now select parts of the main track ending and the silence, then click on Effects, Delay and Reverb, and choose Reverb. Click on Presets and Settings and go to Factory Presets and choose Large Room. Now set the room size to 100% and click Apply. Delete the excess silence. Next, go to File, Export Audio, save your file. I like to save it as both MP3 and WAV format. Congratulations, your first track is now complete. On to step 5. Step 5, preparing our logo for step 6. The next step requires us to prepare our logo for step 6. For this, we will use Photopia.com. It's a free web-based version of Photoshop, but don't worry, I'll make things easy as possible. Here, drag and drop your logo. Now on the toolbar towards the left-hand side, click and hold down your mouse button on this square dotted line icon. This will give us access to the ellipse selection tool. Let's use that. Now, when we click and drag to create a circle, it won't scale in a perfect circle. To create a perfect circle, hold down the shift key and now click and drag to create a circle. Adjust your circle to fit your logo like this. Now go to select and choose inverse. Now click delete on your keyboard. This will leave you with a circle logo and a transparent background. Export your logo as a PNG file to preserve the transparent background by going to File, Export as PNG. Perfect. We're now ready for step 6. Step 6, Audio Reactor Music Video. I prefer this route because it makes our YouTube channel look better. Some people will just upload a stock photo and attach their song and export it as a video. This method works, but let's differentiate ourselves by creating an audio reacting music video. For this, go to... If you head over to my description and click on my Linktree link and select my personal prompts and settings, from there you can download my personal Visi template. Also in this video, I take you step by step and break down the template. So if you want a more customized look, be sure to check that video out. For this tutorial, I'll just use this template. Now let's upload our music by clicking Choose Audio. Next, let's change out the logo by clicking on 2D Spectrum, then click on the preset and click on General. Now let's replace the logo by clicking on this red X button and upload our logo we prepared inside of Photopia. We should now have something like this. Feel free to mess around and create your own. For this, I'll keep this, and now we need to export our video. Click on File, then select Export. This process can take some time. Now that we are done, on to step 7, the lucky number. Step 7, uploading to YouTube. We are practically done. Now we just need to upload the Vizzy music video to our YouTube channel. This process is pretty self-explanatory, but this is a beginner's guide, so I'll take you through this process. You can use ChatGPT if you want to create your title and description. As a tip, I like to create a subfolder on my hard drive with the track title name and move all the MP3, MP4, and WAV files into each folder to stay organized. Go to your YouTube channel and click on Create. Click on Upload Video. Drag and drop your music video here and set your title and description. Set your video tags, and your category should already be set since we did this in step 1. Now the rest of the settings will be fine as default. Click Next, and since it is our first video, we don't need to add cards or end screens, but as you continue to upload more videos, you'll want to add cards and end screens. The rest of the settings should be fine, so continue on. Once everything is done, you should have something like this. And there we have it. You now have an AI music YouTube channel ready to go. There are multiple ways you can go about monetizing this. You could just go with YouTube monetization and run ads. This will require you to get 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 watch hours. Or you could attempt to sell your beats. For me, I'd keep the music free for users and try to monetize through YouTube ads. I'd collect a bunch of songs, upload them individually, and when you have about an hour or two worth of videos, compile them into one large 1 hour long mix. A lot of people listen to music through YouTube and like to find 1 hour long edits. This allows them to set it and forget it, whether they want to work out or listen at work, whatever the case may be. As for this channel, it was simply made to showcase this tutorial. However, feel free to subscribe as I might continue uploading and building this channel. Another thing you could do is upload your tracks to Spotify. Check out this video here where I show you step by step on how to get your AI music uploaded to Spotify, iTunes, etc. If you found value, don't forget to subscribe, and your comments, likes, and sharing of my videos definitely helps me grow and is highly appreciated. I'll catch you on the next video.